cheaper than that of paper bags, with a price of 3 to 5 cents per plastic bag compared to 5 to 23 cents per paper bag. According to NJ, plastic is the winner for stores from a budgeting standpoint. That difference alone saves stores quite a bit of money. Basement called plastic bags a victim of his success. If not for plastic bags that he produces at his company, he wouldn't be where he is today. He said that they are convenient, functional, and inexpensive. They are now everywhere and sometimes overused. Mr. Chairman, switching isn't simple. In the taxing and wilting cases, the goal was not to ban the bags entirely, but to cut down on their use. However, it shows the effort involved in getting the word out about the use of plastic bags versus reusable bags. Residents and employees need to be trained on how to treat reusable bags, understand why they are using them instead of disposable thin plastic bags, and also learn how to use them safely. Mr. Chairman, do you know that the switch from plastic to paper won't be necessarily quick and simple, and without education and sanitizing reusable paper frequently, there could be a health hazard as well. A ban could be detrimental. Mr. Chairman, banning plastic bags in lieu of paper or cotton could have a negative impact on the environment overall. Not to talk of limiting use of these bags to things like lining your trash can, protecting your belongings, or even cleaning up after your dog on a walk. In addition, banning plastic bags could leave a significant number of people without jobs and cost individuals, communities, and also the government money, whether through the purchase of reusable bags or educational programs for the public. Though it may sound like a positive change on the surface, banning plastic bags could actually be detrimental to the environment and the economy. Mr. Chairman, my co-debater said that exposure to plastic causes a whole lot of diseases. But according to the research, plastic actually has half of the carbon footprint of paper. So, Mr. Chairman, how could you imagine what would happen if people were exposed to paper? My debaters, let me give you a bit of face by saying that you are right. As of now, plastic is found on landfills. But if banned, my friends, there are going to be a whole lot of substances that are waste. My co-debater also said that paper disintegrates faster than plastic bags. But in case you did not hear, paper disintegrates at the same rate as plastic. There's a saying that opening gari ria and swasa. Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, given all the convincing points that I and my colleagues have laid down, I strongly stand against the motion that Ghana should ban plastic bags and polythene. Thank you.